Good morning. Morning, Celia. Hey, Aunt G. Good morning, everybody. And once again, welcome to Tuesday Bible Talk Devotional. I pray that during the week, we've all seen, we've all heard, we've all experienced something that has allowed us to grow closer to God and stronger in our faith. As I said last week, God is very busy each and every day showing us his faithfulness. Hey, Mom, his faithfulness to us. So if we just kind of slow down from the busyness, slow down from the hustle and bustle, and take a look around, we'll see that God is doing some wonderful things in our lives, around our lives, to the people in our lives and around our lives. And we could be appreciative of things without the distraction of, you know, the virus and the economy and, you know, all of those things, the tangible things that, while they are real to us, they're not as important as what God is trying to teach us and bringing us through this moment, this season in life. Let us pray. Dear gracious Father, our most wonderful Heavenly Father, we thank you for each and every day that you allow us to continue on this journey of we call life. We thank you, Father, for all your wonderful blessings. We thank you for the heartaches. We thank you for the pain, because we know all things work for the good of those who love you. We bless your efforts, Father. We praise your holy name. And God, we love you. And I just want to say personally, Father, the way you reveal yourself, the things you do in our lives, it reveals our fears. It reveals our weaknesses. But Father, it leans on our faith. So thank you, precious Lord. Thank you for all that you do. And I pray that your holy hand is on the lives of each and every one that can hear my voice, so they will know that you and you alone are the Almighty God. Amen. Well, my scripture reading for today, once again, it's just a reminder, because I think more than anything, we are reborn. We are the people of God, but sometimes this life, this world, takes us by the hand and walks us over in the corner somewhere, and we forget, or it just doesn't come to remembrance, and we just need a subtle reminder, a tap on the shoulder sometimes, because we've gotten away from what the Holy Spirit is saying and stirring in our hearts. And we can't hear it very clearly. So I pray this will help us this day and days moving forward with our journey to eternity. And it comes from Isaiah 40, 28 through 31. This is the English Standard Version. Have you not known? Have you not heard? The Lord is the everlasting God, the creator of the ends of the earth. He does not faint or grow weary. His understanding is unsearchable. He gives power to the faint, and to him who has no might, he increases strength. Even youth shall faint and be weary, and even young men shall fall exhausted. But they who wait on the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings like eagles. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint. I find that a wonderful scripture. Because it just reminds me how we lose sight of God. You know, many times the source of all the troubles in our lives can be found if we just look in the mirror. If we would allow our faith to carry us to a place of understanding that God is made available to all who believe, who truly believe, many of the challenges we face in our walk would just dissipate. Because it's not what happens to you, it's how you deal with what's happening to you. And if you deal with it in the hands of God, that trouble is no trouble anymore. It's just something, it just happened. You know, I'm not talking about anybody, I'm just talking, but many times we are our own worst enemies. We get up and we know the word and we know what we need to do, and we put on the whole armor of God. We are fully equipped. We're ready for the darts, the daggers, everything, the world, Satan and his everything they can present to us. But what we don't put on is the Holy Spirit. So the enemy within is what is conquering us, not the enemy that's outside. You know, so we are armored and we are ready and we are prepared and we are faithful and we're marching on, and we wonder, what is wrong with my march? Well, it's the enemy that's in, because the Holy Spirit is not abiding in you. We take the Holy Spirit, that person is that will bring things to remembrance for us, who empowers us, and we stick him on the shelf. And we say, but I got on the armor of God. But the enemy within starts grinding away with us. And we say, I don't know what's going on. Well, we've got to let the Holy Spirit, the Spirit of God, continually abide in us. His holy temple. We've got to let him in at all times. Never let him out, actually. And we'll find that we are truly, fully protected. Have we not known? Have we not heard? Our mighty God, the creator of heaven and earth, through Christ, he has torn that veil that separated us from being in the right relationship with him. And he's welcomed all who would believe into his unchanging hands, into his precious bosom. He doesn't sleep. He doesn't slumber. He never grows weary. He sees the end from the beginning. So his understanding is unsearchable, because we can't see what he can see. And by that makes his ways so much higher than our ways. So if we're with him, we have somebody who can see the troubles ahead of time and make our way gentle, make that bumpy road smooth, level every mountain, lift every valley, do all those things that his word promised he would do. But we have to let his spirit abide in us. We have to walk with us. So that's why I say, you know, have you not seen? Have you not heard? Don't we all know this? But so sometimes the troubles of the world just make us forget. And those things that could be a bump in the road become troubles in our lives. He gives power to the faint, and to him that has no might, he increases strength. You know, in 2 Corinthians 9, we're told that his grace is sufficient. His power is made perfect in our weakness. So we don't have to be Hercules, but through God, we can give Herculean efforts. You understand? We spend too much time trying to be Hercules, but God wants us to depend on him and give him a Herculean effort by his grace all the time. So we've got to stop relying on ourselves and start relying on him when we remember, when we've heard, when we've seen. His power will only manifest when we let go to God the Father, through God the Son, to be empowered by God the Holy Spirit. You know, why doesn't it work for me? Because you haven't let go in those ways and let the Holy Spirit empower you to be that thing that God wants you to be. But, you know, it's funny, but why doesn't God just, because he won't force his will on you, because he loves us oh so much. He is so just to us. He's such a perfect gentleman. He doesn't force his will on us. He lets us know. He gives us subtle reminders, but he won't force you. He won't force you into that beautiful life. He won't force you to accept his grace, love, and mercy in every circumstance. But he makes it oh so available to you that it is there. All you've got to do is want it. But he gives his elect the free will to do his will or to do their will. I submit to you, when you do your will, how does that work out on you? That's what this scripture is about. You know, he's reminding us that even the virile, the ones that haven't been beaten up and torn by age and by the things of life, that haven't been worn down, those that can boast in their strength and might, can't endure the challenges of this world and of this life without him. They'll grow weary. They'll become exhausted. It'll wear you down when you try to do it by yourself. But here's the thing. Here's the wonderful part of his promise to all the faithful. If we wait on the Lord, if we quit trying to do our way, will, our way, and our understanding at our pace, but instead we operate in his will, at his pace, at his superior understanding, he will renew our strength. We will become more than conquerors, not just conquerors to overcome the things of the world, but more than conquerors. You know, you ever look at our church or our sister churches when we go visit or they come over to worship with us? And you look at those, as Pastor Taylor says, those recycled teenagers and the vim and the vigor. I mean, they're vibrant. They worship God. They add so much muster to the service. Their strength has been renewed to praise God fully. Isn't that what we want for our lives? We want to be recycled teenagers. We want to walk in God's grace with the strength and understanding that his mercy allows us to keep on. If we remember, you know, in the beginning of the Bible, Abraham was 75 when he started his walk in vibrance. Moses was 80 when he got his call. And he operated better than that man 40 years before that was this great general and scholar and all these things. Because of God, God empowered him. He allowed God in to empower him to do those things. So he'll renew your strength if you'll just wait on him and trust him. So I know the bones get achy. The trials seem a little hard. Things get heavy. Hand them over to the Lord. He'll renew your strength. And you can just keep on moving. Keep on moving. But that's just a start. He says, we'll mount up with wings like eagles. And just to context that, you know, eagles molt. They refresh their feathers well into their old age, and it allows them to still soar higher than any other bird. It allows them to keep their strength up. Okay, well, that's our relationship with God. We don't have to do that for ourselves. By our weaknesses, his strength manifests, and then we become strong because he abides in us. We'll mount up with wings like eagles. We will soar. If we will wait on the Lord and we will trust him. Don't get too fast to say, I got to do, I need to do. When God says it's time to move, it's time to move. He will give you the power. He will sustain you. He will move you from glory to glory. But you've got to wait on the Lord. You've got to be patient. You've got to watch and wait. And when he says move, move in his strength. Move in his power. Be like that eagle. Operate so stealthily, so wonderfully into an old and prime and beautiful age. Let God's glory shine through you. You'll run and not be weary. You'll walk and not faint. This is a spiritual thing. You know, spiritually, you'll keep on running, just like I talked about when we do those shared services, or even just in our personal service, because our body of Christ is tainted toward seniors. Look at the service. Look at our mothers sitting up there. Look at those mothers, revived and powerful and praising God. They're running and not being weary. They're walking and not being faint. They take the time and come up those ramps and all the way into that sanctuary to praise God at 80 plus, some 90 plus. Because God renews their strength for his service, for his will, to praise him, to relate, to be in relationship with him. That's what we need. So when times are hard, and you know, Satan's tapping you on your back, and you say, I don't want nothing to do with church. I don't want nothing to do with corporate worship. I don't want to hear it. I don't want to deal with it. See, that's when you need to wait on the Lord. Because he's standing there saying, yes, you do. Actually, what you need in this time is me. God is saying, you need him in that time. But those are the very times we want to take and just put it away. I don't want to hear it because I'm tired. I'm worn. The world's just been jabbing and sucker punching me. I'm just so beat up. Well, God is saying, have you not heard? It's me. Give it to me. Turn it over to me. If you wait on me, I will refresh you. I will renew you. I will make you strong again. So if this 2020, if it has worn you out, the financial worries, the worries about illness, sickness, and pain, and watching your loved ones pass, and friends and family pass, and hearing about people just and the almost 500,000 deaths here in America that probably could have been avoided. If this stuff is wearing on you, if it's making you feel defeated, if it's making you ask questions, what is going on? God is saying to you, wait on me. Wait on me. Wait on me. I will renew you. I will give you the strength to mount up and soar. I will make you able to run and not be weary, to walk and not be faint. That is what we need right now, because all of our constitutions are diminished and we need to be re-strengthened. So my word for today is we need to wait on the Lord. He's here. He's working. He's doing all those things to put us where we need to be. And if you are faithful to wait on him and watch him do what only God can do, all is well. Amen. I want to thank you all for another wonderful Tuesday, and God bless you. Have a great week, and we'll see you next week. It's God's will. Amen.